Hello everyone and welcome back to Easy Dentistry, a channel that makes dental education incredibly easy and interesting. If you have not yet done, please subscribe to our channel right now and also don't forget to put on the notification bell so that whenever I upload a new lecture, you get a notification. Today's lecture is a very important topic in microbiology, that is sterilization and disinfection. We would be studying this long important topic in three parts. In part 1, we will be studying the basic concepts as well as the physical methods of sterilization. In part 2, we would be studying the heat sterilization methods. This heat sterilization is the most important part of the chapter, so we would be uploading a separate detailed lecture on it. And in part 3, we will be studying the chemical methods of sterilization. So let's begin with part 1. In this part, we will be first studying few definitions which are extremely important from your Viva point of view. Then we will be studying the classification of sterilization, and then we will be studying the physical methods of sterilization in detail. Specifically, we will be studying about the sunlight, ozone, filtration and the radiation methods of sterilization. Then we will, in part 2, we will be separately uploading the heat methods of sterilization, where we will be studying in detail the dry heat and the moist heat methods. So coming to the introduction and definition, the microorganisms which are responsible for infection are present at all places, that is they are omnipresent. These microorganisms cause contamination and infection. So the aim of sterilization is to destroy these microorganisms from the material or surfaces so as to reduce the infection and contamination caused. So coming to the definition, what is sterilization? Sterilization is a process in which the article, surface or medium is made free of all microorganisms, both the vegetative as well as spore form. So the definition of sterilization, it is the process by which an article, surface or medium is made free of all microorganisms, both the vegetative forms as well as the spore forms. Then what is disinfection? This disinfection is different from sterilization. Let us study the definition of disinfection. So disinfection means destruction of all pathogens or organisms which are capable of producing infection. But disinfection need not necessarily remove the spore form. So in sterilization, both the vegetative as well as the spore forms are removed. But in disinfection, it is not a guarantee that the spore forms would be removed. So in disinfection, all organisms are not destroyed, but the number of the microorganisms is reduced to such a level that it is no longer harmful. The number is reduced so that it is no longer harmful. Now, what are the antiseptics? Antiseptics are chemical disinfectants which can be safely applied to living tissues, and they inhibit the growth of microorganisms. So they can be safely applied to the living tissues, to the human skin or the mucous membrane, and they inhibit the growth of the pathogenic microorganisms. Now what is asepsis? Now asepsis is a technique. Remember, it is a technique by which the occurrence of infection into an uninfected tissue is prevented. Remember, this is also a very important definition. It is a technique by which the spread of infection from an infected tissue to an uninfected tissue is prevented. Now, after studying these four important definitions, let us study the use of sterilization or disinfection. So, sterilization of material or instruments is used in surgical and diagnostic purposes. Then, sterilization methods are used for sterilizing the media and reagents used in microbiology labs. And it is mostly used in food and drug manufacturing industry to ensure safety from contaminating organisms. So these are the three main applications of sterilization and disinfection. Firstly, in surgical and diagnostic methods. Secondly, for sterilization of the media and reagents used in labs. And thirdly, most importantly, the food and drug manufacturing industry for safety against contaminating organisms. Now let us study the classification of sterilization. The methods of sterilization are divided into physical methods and chemical methods. The physical methods include sunlight, heat, ozone, filtration, and radiation. This heat is further divided into dry heat and moist heat, but these are the five major types of physical methods of sterilization: the sunlight, heat, ozone, filtration, and radiation. Then the chemical methods include use of various chemicals such as alcohol, aldehydes, phenols, halogens, certain oxidizing agents, salts, certain surface active agents, certain dyes, and vapor phase disinfectants. So these are the various chemical methods of sterilization. Now let us study the physical methods in detail. First is the sunlight. The sunlight has ultraviolet rays in it, which are specifically germicidal. So it is a natural method of sterilization of tanks, river, of water present in the tanks, rivers, and lakes, because the UV rays present in the sunlight is germicidal. Then the heat sterilization is further divided into dry heat and moist heat. We will be uploading a separate video on this heat sterilization. The next video would be on the heat sterilization. Thirdly, the ozone. The ozone method of sterilization can be described as low temperature sterilization by ozone. So, in an ozone sterilizer, oxygen, water, and electricity is used to provide ozone, and these ozone is used in sterilization. And the advantage of this method is that no toxic chemicals are produced by this method. The production of ozone occurs at a low temperature, that is at 25 to 35 degrees Celsius. In this device, oxygen is separated into atomic oxygen. The oxygen is passed through an intense electric field and is separated into atomic oxygen. Now this atomic oxygen, it combines with other oxygen molecules to form ozone. Now this is a diagrammatic representation in which the oxygen is separated into atomic oxygen molecules, and this atomic oxygen, it combines with other oxygen molecules to form the ozone, and this ozone is used for sterilization. Now this ozone provides a sterility assurance of 10 to the power minus 6 in almost 4 hours. So remember, this is another MCQ question. The ozone provides a sterilization assurance of 10 to the power minus 6 in approximately 4 hours. Then the fourth method is the filtration method. In this filtration method, the substance which are damaged by heat, such as the serum, sugars, and antibiotics, these substances which are damaged by heat are sterilized by the method of filtration. So the uses of filtration is to sterilize the sera, sugar and antibiotic solution, for the separation of toxins and bacteriophages from bacteria. Thirdly, to obtain a bacteria-free filtrate for virus isolation. Then for the sterilization of hydrated fluid. Then filter disc is used to retain the organisms, and further this disc is cultured to know the causative organism. This filter disc is mostly used for testing of water samples for cholera vibrio. Then the fifth use of filtration is in water purification. But the limitation of filtration is that the pore size of the filters which is used is 0.75 micrometer, which retains bacteria. But the viruses and mycoplasma can pass through this pore size, and therefore the filtered preparations are not safe for clinical use. Now there are six types of filters used. First is the candle filter, example of which is Birkfield filter and Chamberlain filter. Then comes the asbestos disc filter, the example of which is Seitz filter. There is the sintered glass filter, membrane filter, air filter and syringe filter. Now let us study the candle filters in detail. The candle filters are mostly used for the purification of water for industrial as well as in domestic purposes. These filters are usually made up of hollow candles. The grade of porosity of these candles is different. The liquids pass through these candles. There are two types of candle filters, the diatomaceous earth filters and the unglazed porcelain filters. The diatomaceous earth filters are called as Birkfield filters, while the unglazed porcelain filters are called as the Chamberlain filters. So these are the example of candle filters in which you can see these are the candles through which water passes, and this is the discharge, that is the impurities present in the water which has accumulated on the filter, candles of the filter. Now second comes the asbestos filter or the Seitz filter. This is another important topic to remember, the Seitz filter. These are made up of asbestos or magnesium silicate. The filter disc made up of asbestos is supported on a metal mount. The filter is attached to a vacuum flask through a silicone rubber bung. After use, the filter disc is discarded, and each time a fresh disc is used, and the metal component of this filter is sterilized by autoclaving. Autoclaving we will be studying in detail in the next lecture. So this is a diagram of Seitz filter in which the asbestos filter pad is mounted on a metal frame and it is used for filtration. Then third is the sintered glass filter. These are prepared by fusing finely powdered glass particles. The pore size of this sintered glass filters vary. So here these are different pore size of the sintered glass filters. Then the fourth type is the membrane filters. The membrane filters are made up of cellulose ester. Another important point to remember, the membrane filters are made up of cellulose esters, and these are mostly used for water analysis, sterility test and for preparation of solutions for parenteral use. Nitrocellulose filters, also called as the millipore filters, are widely used, and these have a pore size of 0.015 to 12 micrometer. 0.22 micrometer filter is the most commonly used membrane filter, which filters away even the smaller bacteria. Now, these membrane filters are used to determine the bacterial count in water. So how is this bacterial count in water determined? Known amount of water is filtered through the membrane disc, and then this membrane disc is cultured. The colonies of bacteria grown gives the viable count of bacteria in the water. So water is passed through this membrane filter, and then this membrane is placed over the appropriate nutrient media and incubated, and the growth of typical colonies occur, and then these colonies are counted to determine the bacterial count of the water. And the fifth type of filter is the air filter. These filters are used to deliver clean, bacteria-free air to a cubicle or a room. The HEPA filters, the full form of which is high efficiency particulate air filters, are used in air filtration, in laminar airflow system, in microbiology labs. The HEPA filters have a pore size of 0.3 micrometer, so even the smaller particles are removed. So here you can see the HEPA filter, in which the particles are removed by the use of these filters and clean air is released. Now, the sixth type is the syringe filters. The syringes fitted with membrane of different diameters. The syringes are fitted with membranes, and these membranes have pores of different diameters. Fluid is forced through this membrane with the help of syringe, and when this fluid passes through the pores of different pore size, the sterilization of the fluid occurs. So here is a diagram in which you can see the syringe, which is fitted with membranes of different diameter. This fluid is forced through this disc, and then you can find sterilized fluid. Now, the last part of this today's lecture, the fifth method of physical sterilization is radiation. Now, there are two types of radiations used for sterilization: ionizing and non-ionizing. The ionizing radiations include gamma radiation, X-rays, and cosmic radiation. These have very high penetrating power, and these radiations are lethal to the bacteria and they cause bacterial DNA damage. The gamma radiations, which are produced from a cobalt-60 source, is used for the sterilization of disposable items such as plastic syringes, swabs, culture plates, cannula, and catheter. This method of sterilization using the ionizing radiation is also called as cold sterilization. Remember, another important point to remember here, what is cold sterilization? And the advantages of using this cold sterilization is that it has high penetrating power and also can pass through the plastic packages. Now, another important point to remember here, the Bacillus pumilis is used for testing the efficacy of these ionizing radiation. Now comes the non-ionizing radiation. The non-ionizing radiations are made up of infrared and ultraviolet radiations. The infrared radiations is used for rapid mass sterilization of syringes and catheters, while the ultraviolet radiation with a wavelength of 240 to 280 nm has marked bactericidal effect, and it causes the denaturation of bacterial proteins and prevent the bacterial DNA replication. Uses of UV radiation is in sterilization of the labs, inoculation hoods, and in operation theaters. But The major question in using non-ionizing radiation is that the vegetative forms are definitely killed, but the spores are highly resistant and the viruses are, the susceptibility of the viruses is variable. So, complete sterilization cannot be assured by non-ionizing radiation. So, here we complete with the lecture on physical methods. Yes, I know the heat methods are remaining, which we would be studying in the next lecture. Please subscribe to our channel. Thanks for watching and happy studying.